Hello students, I hope you all are well and staying at home. I welcome you all in class 8. Today we are going to start chapter 1, rational numbers. But before starting this topic, we just revise some basic terms which you already done in your previous classes. Natural numbers. Numbers which are starting from 1 are called natural numbers. It is represented by n, and the numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Next is whole numbers. Numbers which are starting from 0 are called whole numbers. It is represented by W, and the numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. As you see here, all natural numbers are including in whole numbers. Next is integers. All positive numbers, negative numbers including 0 are called integers. It is represented by I or Z, and the numbers are minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Rational numbers. A number can be expressed in the form P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0, is called a rational number. For example, 2, 4, 3 upon 5, minus 6, 0 upon 7, 2 by 3, etc. are some examples of rational number. As you see here, 2 and 4 are written as 2 upon 1 and 4 upon 1. So, it is represented in the form P upon Q. So, taking as an example of rational numbers. Now, some important facts. Every natural number or whole number or integer is a rational number, but the opposite may not be true always. Two rational numbers are equivalent if they have the same value. The value of a rational number does not change if both numerator and denominator of the rational number are multiplied or divided by the same non-zero integer. Next is, all terminating decimal number are rational. And last, a rational number P upon Q is said to be in standard form or simplest form if P and Q have no common factor other than 1. Now, operations on rational numbers. Case 1 is, if P upon Q and R upon Q are any two rational numbers with common denominator Q. As you see here, P upon Q and R upon Q having same denominator. So, when we add them, P upon Q plus R upon Q is equal to P plus R upon Q. Here, you see an example. 6 upon 13 plus minus 2 upon 13 is equal to 6 minus 2 upon 13, that is equal to 4 upon 13. Case 2 is, if P upon Q and R upon S are any two rational numbers with different denominator, then take LCM and express given rational number with this LCM as the common denominator. As you see here, P upon Q and R upon S, they having different denominator. One having denominator Q and other having denominator S. So, first we convert in common denominator by taking LCM. So, we get P upon Q plus R upon S is equal to PS plus RQ upon QS. If you take an example, it is 1 upon 8 plus 3 upon 4. The LCM of 8 and 4 is 8. And we get 1 plus 6 upon 8, that is equal to 7 upon 8. Now, properties of addition of rational numbers. First is closure property. If A upon B and C upon D be any two unique rational numbers, then A upon B plus C upon D is a rational number. If we take an example, 2 plus 3 can be written as 2 upon 1 plus 3 upon 1 is equal to 5 upon 1, or simply 5 is a rational number. Therefore, closure property exists in rational numbers. Second is commutative property. A upon B plus C upon D is equal to C upon D plus A upon B. That is, two rational numbers can be added in any order. Let us take an example. If we add 2 plus 3, it will come 5. And if we change the order 3 plus 2, then the answer remains the same, that is 5. It means when we interchange the order of rational numbers, addition will remain same. Third one is associative property. For any three rational numbers, A upon B, C upon D, E upon F, we have A upon B plus C upon D plus E upon F is equal to A upon B plus C upon D plus E upon F. Here you see that we take first two rational numbers in bracket, and in right hand side we take next two rational numbers, that is second and third rational number taken in same bracket, and then adding them. While adding three or more rational numbers, they can be grouped in any order. Property of zero. The sum of any rational number and zero is a rational number itself. That is, if A upon B is any rational number, then A upon B plus zero is equal to 0 plus A upon B is equal to A upon B. It means if we consider an example, 2 plus 0 or 0 plus 2, answer will remain 2. Fifth is negative of a rational number. If A upon B is a rational number, then minus A upon B is a rational number such that A upon B plus minus A upon B is equal to minus A upon B plus A upon B is equal to 0. Here you see that A upon B and minus A upon B both are equal and opposite sign, so they cancel each other and result will be 0. As you see that minus A upon B is called negative of A upon B, so it is also called additive inverse of A upon B. Properties of subtraction. First property is closure property. If A upon B and C upon D are any two rational numbers, then A upon B minus C upon D is also a rational number. If we take an example, 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. 1 is a rational number, so closure property exists in subtraction. Second is existence of right identity. For any rational number A upon B, A upon B minus 0 is equal to A upon B, but 0 minus A upon B is equal to minus A upon B. Therefore, only the right identity exists for subtraction. Here we see that in first case, 0 is subtracted from A upon B, so answer is A upon B. And in second case, 0 minus A upon B, we get minus A upon B. Both results are same but having opposite sign. So existence of right identity exists for subtraction. Now, the most important topic is subtraction is not commutative and associative for rational numbers. Here we are taking an example. You see here 2 by 5 plus 8 by 3 plus minus 11 by 15 plus 4 by 5 plus minus 2 by 3. To solve this equation by simplest way, we first group pair of numbers with a common denominator. So here you see that I take 2 by 5 plus 4 by 5 in a bracket and 8 by 3 plus minus 2 upon 3 is taking in another bracket. Because in both brackets, in first bracket 5 as a denominator and in second bracket 3 is taking as a denominator. Now we solve this, we get 6 upon 5 plus 6 upon 3 minus 11 upon 15. By taking the LCM of 5, 3 and 15, we get 18 plus 30 minus 11 upon 15. And 18 plus 30 is equal to 48 minus 11 upon 15. At last, we get 37 upon 15 is the answer. Now, properties of multiplication. First property is closer property. The product of two rational numbers is always a rational number if a upon b and c upon d are any two rational numbers, then a upon b multiply c upon d is also a rational number. If we take an example, 2 multiply 3, result is 6. And 6 is a rational number because 6 upon 1 can be written in the form of P upon Q. Second is commutative property. Two rational numbers can be multiplied in any order. Thus, if A upon B and C upon D are any rational number, then A upon B multiply C upon D is equal to C upon D multiply A upon B. If we take an example, 2 multiply 3 is equal to 6. Now we change the order of numbers, 3 multiply 2, that is also 6. So we can say that if we interchange the order of rational numbers, resultant will be same. Third is associative property. While multiplying 3 or more rational numbers, they can be grouped in any order. Thus, if A upon B, C upon D and E upon F are three rational numbers, then A upon B multiply C upon D multiply E upon F is equal to A upon B multiply C upon D multiply E upon F. Fourth is property of 1. If A upon B is a rational number, then A upon B multiply 1 is equal to 1 multiply A upon B is equal to A upon B. It means if any rational number is multiplied by 1, resultant will be the same rational number. Therefore, 1 is called multiplicative identity for rational numbers. Fifth is multiplication by 0. Every rational number multiplied with 0 gives 0. That is, A upon B multiply 0 is equal to 0 multiply A upon B is equal to 0. It means any rational number, when we multiply it by 0, we always get result 0. Like 2 multiply 0 is equal to 0. Now, 6 is distributivity of multiplication over addition. If A upon B, C upon D and E upon F are rational numbers, then A upon B multiply C upon D plus E upon F is equal to A upon B multiply C upon D plus A upon B multiply E upon F. Here in right hand side we just open the bracket and then simplify. Now seventh is existence of multiplicative inverse. Every non-zero rational number A upon B has its multiplicative inverse B upon A. It is also known as reciprocal. Thus, A upon B multiply B upon A is equal to b upon a multiply a upon b is equal to 1. Now consider an example by taking three rational numbers 4 by 5, minus 3 by 4 and 5 by 6. As you see here, in left hand side we get the result 1 by 15 and in right hand side we also get the result 1 by 15. Since left hand side is equal to right hand side, so both sides are equal and property of distributivity of multiplication over addition exists. Now the properties of division. First is, if a upon b and c upon d are two rational numbers such that c upon d is not equal to 0, then a upon b divide c upon d is always a rational number. Second is, for any rational number a upon b, we have a upon b divided 1 is equal to a upon b and a upon b divide minus 1 is equal to minus a upon b. Third one is, for every non-zero rational number a upon b, we have a upon b divide a upon b is equal to 1. Second case, a upon b divide minus a upon b, we get minus 1. In third part, minus a upon b divide a upon b is equal to minus 1. Now to find rational numbers between two given rational numbers. Let a upon b and c upon d are two rational numbers such that a upon b is less than c upon d. Then to find rational numbers, the formula is 1 by 2 a plus b plus c upon d is a rational number lying between a upon b and c upon d. Let us take an example. Find a rational number between 1 by 3 and 1 by 4. So let us take a is equal to 1 by 3 and b is equal to 1 by 4. Now the required rational number is equal to 1 by 2, 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. First of all, we take the LCM of 3 and 4. By solving the bracket, we get 4 plus 3 upon 12 is equal to 7 upon 12. Now 7 by 12 multiplied by 1 by 2, we get 7 upon 24. It means 7 upon 24 lies between 1 by 3 and 1 by 4. Similarly, we can find many rational numbers between given rational numbers by taking the equivalent fractions with common denominator. As you see, this solution, I think all you understand about the solution. At last, thank you all for watching this video.